This is a shoe that belonged to Robert Wadlow, the tallest human recorded in history. He's in the Guinness Book of World Records. It was a shoe he gave to my grandfather in 1934.
And why did he give it to your grandfather?
Well, my grandfather was a local merchant here in Knoxville. He was the local representative for Peter's Shoes out of St. Louis, Missouri. And Peter's made shoes for Robert Wadlow. And in turn, Robert Wadlow went, traveled around and on promotional tours. He came here to Knoxville in 1934. He and my grandfather struck up a nice relationship, and he was a very nice young man. And before he left, he gave him a shoe.
He's from Alton, Illinois, outside St. Louis, born in 1918. He is recorded as the tallest, irrefutably the tallest man recorded. There have been other ideas of people elsewhere in the world, but there's actual documentation of him and photos. And he was an American celebrity. He had his shoes custom made for him, that they had to be. This is a size 35.
Yes.
A normal man's shoe today is about a 10 and a half. So in the 20s and 30s, it may have been about a 9 and a half or so. So a size 35 was a particularly important shoe for people.
Yes.
Who knows where the other one is? Maybe give it to another shoe store. He was on his promotional tour. Embroidered here in the inside is Peter's for the shoe company. It's wearing off now, but they would have been hand embroidered for these custom shoes. And also on the bottom, we see Peter's diamond brand. He came here and he hadn't reached his full height. He was 7 feet, 11.1 inches.
Mm-hmm.
He died in 1940.
Yes.
The brace that he used for his legs is he had to be supported early on just to be able to walk and support his frame. He got a blister and he got an infection.
Mm-hmm.
They gave him a transfusion and he died 11 days later.
Wow.
And when he died, he was 8 feet, 11.1 inches. So he had a whole other foot to grow here. And he was documented as still growing even at his death at 22. He died needing 12 pallbearers. His casket was 10 feet long and half a ton.
Wow.
His family was worried that the body was going to be tampered with, so they interred it in solid cement, in concrete, so no one would tamper with it. This is going to be of interest to collectors.
Oh, yes.
And collectors for quirky things.
Mm-hmm.
I would put an auction estimate of $1,500 to $2,500 at auction. Thank you so much for bringing it.
Oh, thank you.
It's a great piece of American history.